In 1977, Ha Yan-yoon, a dancer at the Gansu Provincial Song and Dance Troupe, was studying murals at the Morgao Grottoes in China's Gansu province. At grotto number 112, she saw a flying deity playing the pipa behind her back. She was immediately struck by this extraordinary figure, feeling it needed to be studied further.
那我最关注的，或最吸引我的，那很肯定、很自然就是一些舞蹈动态的东西。可恰恰东方壁画呢，舞蹈动态的东西是非常非常之多。我那时候才刚刚二十，应该是二十几岁，二十一二岁吧，就认为是人间的非常美丽的一个世界，是我们在现实生活当中看不到的。This
mural was created in the middle of the Tang Dynasty. The dancer in the mural is playing the pipa behind her back while performing complex dance moves. Seeing such an intricate blend of dancing moves came as a great shock to dancers like Ha Yan-yoon.
反弹琵琶里头，那个人很费劲。你看那个大指头，你没看那个图，大指头好，敲得好高，好像全身的力气都使在那个指头上了。他的细腻呀。 就是表现在他的末梢的都有动作，啊，手是在这儿拿着琵琶，这个手是在后边反弹的姿势，身体是大幅度的前倾，这个腿呢是膝的最前最前，那么胯是往后推，为什么要往后推胯？这是一个舞蹈，说明他很懂舞蹈这个画家。
那时候的人不可能不像我们现在那画速写啊，他肯定是。 在观察和不断的在小稿上推敲，最后把最完美的形状形象，固确定下来。头、颈、这个肩、腰、臀、腿，他这几个曲线的安排，这个精心的这种设计，我觉得已经达到了100%非常完美的地步。
There are 39 dancers and musicians in the mural inside grotto number 112. All are well-shaped and vivid. Grotto number 112 contains the greatest number of murals depicting singing and dancing, and has thus been nicknamed the Music Grotto. But the figure playing the pipa behind her back can't be found in any historical records. The dance move hasn't survived to the present. Was it just something that came from the imagination of the Tang Dynasty painters? The pipa is a four-stringed Chinese musical instrument that was introduced from the Western regions. It's frequently mentioned in many frontier poems of the Tang Dynasty. So at the time, the pipa was already quite popular. It had even become a symbol of music during the Tang Dynasty, when people were very much captivated by the songs and dances from the Western regions.
在汉以前，古琴是音乐的形象，是一种徽符号。在汉以后，琵琶是符号。
The pipa is the most frequently depicted musical instrument in the Dunhuang murals. According to Zhang Ruzhong, there are over 700 different pipas depicted in the murals, making them a living museum. Zheng has painted all the pipas that appear in the murals. This covers almost every type of pipa that has existed in the history of China. After the Tang and Song dynasties, Chinese rulers were less willing to accept foreign influences. As the country gradually became more conservative, closed and inward, Chinese music saw a steep decline. By the 18th century, not a single pipa player could be found.
康熙有一天召集会议，康熙就讲说：“你们去调查调查，我怎么听着现在这琵琶现在都听不见了？说你们调查调查，我小时候在哪个哪个地方还听着一个老头在弹琵琶，你们去访问访问，看看这人还在不在？有这样的一段历史，就说明那个清代的音乐也趋于没落、衰败。”
Dunhuang murals also changed during the Tang Dynasty, more than 1,000 years ago. The number of murals depicting the life of Buddha declined, while those showing Buddhist sutras began to appear. The figure shown playing the pipa behind her back is a typical example of this.
经嘛就是指佛教的经典了，变呢它是有一个转变的意思，所以这个经变呢。实际上就是把这个抽象的一些哲学性的那些佛教的道理把它转变成一个通俗的大家能够可以感受到的这样一个形象，这个画面是普通人都能够感受到的，能够从中体会这个佛经的一些道理。那么经变伎乐呢，实际上就是在经变画当中表现出来的那些伎乐天。
The Buddhist paradise depicted in the murals has fixed characteristics, namely flying apsaras playing music and scattering flowers. They also show Buddha preaching his teachings while the gods listen carefully as dancers move to the music.
用佛国世界嘛，它离不开要歌舞升平，要跳舞唱歌的。由于这个唐朝啊，这个音乐舞蹈本身就很发达。在这样发达的情况下，那个画家他可以感受到，他可以看到那些宫廷音乐啊，那么漂亮的，那么跳舞唱歌有那么辉煌的，所以他才能表现出很宏伟的那些音乐舞蹈的场面。
The music and dance scenes differ from the stories of Buddha's life and secular tales. They usually contain hundreds of people playing music.Singing and dancing on a large scale, all in a well-arranged manner, which even surpasses the imperial musical bands of the time.
他反弹琵琶不仅仅是这一个反弹琵琶的舞姿，它有很多很多种反弹琵琶，有站着的，有跪着的，有反着的，有正着的，啊，那琵琶前拿的，后拿的，那么有仰着的，有卧着。
Since the Mid Tang Dynasty.More and more depictions of the pipa being played behind the back began to appear in murals. According to scholars, these might have been introduced to Dunhuang when the area was controlled by Tibetan kingdoms.
我这个反弹琵琶是怎么回事啊？我怎么在中唐分期他写个不中唐，中唐就是吐蕃下来统治了，就是吞并了。吞并了这个河西走廊一带。
There are also many murals showing dancers with long flowing ribbons. It turns out that these were depictions of imperial dances of the Tang Dynasty. Such dance moves are still frequently seen in today's ribbon dances.
和壁画上一样，满周围都是花，从低到高，预备，走，一、二、三、四、五、六，你往前打，六大、七大、八。
Like the ribbon dance, many dances depicted in the murals have been passed down to the present day. Yet, no traces of the pipa being played behind the back can be found anywhere.
This 反弹琵琶这种造型，在别的寺院里头和别的同样的画或者史书里是不见的。它甚至还是。以这个敦煌壁画的粉本的流传，甚至的影响的新疆，我看新疆有。
For a long time, He Yan Yun looked at herself in the mirror as she tried to play the pipa behind her back. But the only reference she had to go by was the frozen posture in the mural. She had to imagine what the dance may have been like.Although she was very familiar with classical dance, ballet, and ethnic dance, her former experience was of no use.
你怎么尊重历史？怎么依据历史的这个壁画的依据，它的这些提供给你的这些视觉的冲击和那些感受，那么用我们的肢体语言去把它表现出来和连接起来，然后整体化。展示给观众。
The instrument has usually been held vertically in the player's arms. Some experts argue that the pipa wouldn't be able to produce a tune when played behind the back. The posture may have been adopted just to show off the performer's dancing skills.
我说这种弹法，你能够弹到白居易写的那个《琵琶行》，嘈嘈切切搓杂弹，大珠小珠罗衣盘，能够有这些效果吗？我说不瞎扯吗？他说你真是，他说他就是弹个节奏。哎，我说他为什么要这样？他说他是弦乐技巧，
绝对有生活依据的，因为是瞎子阿炳。华阿炳是亲自讲过，有这种体会，就说他们为了招揽观众，可以把乐器用各种方式演奏，为什么呢？招揽观众。所以这个动作虽然它是更美化，啊，那个更漂亮，但是它生活依据是有的，圆形的复制，唰唰，这种感觉。主力腿你就往后推胯，他就永远都站得住。对。
The posture is just one moment in the dance that has been captured in the blink of an eye. So to create a coherent dance move, dancers have to find out how body language works.
扭曲和弯曲，那他的有些弯曲是在画家的笔下是非常优美的，甚至可以画得非常弯曲。那么在我们正常人的情况下，我们是否能够完全达到？这个可能对我们也是一大难题。这其一，其二，一个一个静止的动作，你怎么把它连贯起来？
后来我就琢磨，这个运动线路啊，你必须是 S 型的，它才会像东方壁画。啊，当时我们一开始是模仿嘛，它才能像，它才能有那个味道，它才能不同于古典舞，因为我们已经走不通了，按照古典舞的那个老路子走，老走出来还是古典舞，不像东方舞。
In the end, with the help of her troupe's director, He Yan Yun, successfully recreated the dance move of the pipa being played behind the back. In 1979, as the leading actress in the dance drama Flowers of the Silk Road, He Yan Yun performed the unusual dance move on stage for the first time. From then on, the posture has been an enduring dance image associated with China. Simply by recreating a single dance move from the Dunhuang murals, artists were able to stun audiences all over the world. The dance drama, Flowers of the Silk Road, not only revived the dance, but also recreated scenes from the Buddhist paradise depicted at Grotto No. 112. In 1981, a statue of a flying deity playing the pipa behind her back was erected in Dunhuang and has since become a well-known symbol of the city. The success of the Flowers of the Silk Road uncovered just one secret of the Dunhuang dance. There are more treasures waiting to be discovered. Xia Min also participated in the first version of the Flowers of the Silk Road. She later became the third performer to take on the leading role.
摆一下，他那个位置有点不对，你摆一下，对，你也坐一下，你也坐一下，大，看人是正的，身体不要倾，你身体是倾的。After
retiring from the stage, she's been teaching at the Beijing Dance Academy, continuing her Dunhuang dancing dream in a different way.
走，大，一。
一二三四五六七八，敦煌契约，静谧安详，应是垂暮的静思，佛骨世界冥想，临音符，气势惊人，组合一句二七二姑北凉契约。
Most of these young dancers haven't been to Dunhuang yet. Under Xia's direction, they are getting closer and closer to that dream, one step at a time.
So I think Dunhuang舞的这个，就像铭心刻骨的，进入到血液一样的。
As the lead actress, Xia has danced with the pipa behind her back many times. But as she studied and taught in Beijing, she once thought of dropping Dunhuang dance.
觉得自己都啥也都不对了，你知道吗？因为学院派的体系嘛，啊。 啊，后来呢，就是杨丽萍，知道吗？啊，她的那个当时的那个读物晚会，就大大对我是一种刺激，啊，又让我又进行了一个反思，使我又找到了自我，就是说呢，还是要继续敦煌舞的这样的一个表演。
In 2009, Xia finally fulfilled her dream of creating a duet dance based on playing the pipa behind the back, breathing new life into the dance.
小点儿，哎，对啊，我希望呢，你们呢在表演这个组合当中呢，啊，就是好像自己就是那个反弹琵琶女，同时呢又自己就是那个反弹琵琶，就是那个琵琶的身，哎呀，有时候还要化成什么反弹琵琶弹出的那个音。
Xia's dance emphasizes the mutual understanding between the dancers and the audience.She pursues a free spirit towards stepping out of the secular world. To enjoy and understand her dance, the performers don't even need to hold a real pipa in their hands. A pipa seems to be everywhere, hidden behind their postures and gestures. What Xia is searching for is the dance posture's soul.Why did emperors of the Tang Dynasty enjoy the whirling dance so much? Has the Xi Liang song and dance depicted in the Dunhuang murals disappeared? Can this ancient and mysterious music and dance form still be found along today's Silk Road? Join us for part 3, Exotic Music and Dance.